Myself, Bhautik Trivedi, working as an assistant professor in IT-ICT department of LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. I will explain you the concept of MAC based on hash function in information and network security subject. So first of all of you know the concept of message authentication, the concept of MAC. What is the meaning of MAC? That is known as a message authentication code. And how I generate the MAC? So if I want to generate the MAC, what's the formula behind that? The formula is that C in bracket K comma M. What is the meaning of C? C means cryptographic checksum. K means that is the key. And M means that is the message. So here in today's session, fully focus on the concept of MAC based on hash function. And MAC based on hash function, that is also known as a HMAC. What is the meaning of H? H means hash base. And what is the meaning of MAC? MAC means message authentication code. So this particular topic, that is also known as a concept of HMAC. So let's start with the concept of HMAC. First of all, H means all of you know that is the hash. MAC means all of you know that is the message authentication code, and that is known as a hash based message authentication code. So cryptographic hash function, any proper example of the cryptographic hash function, any proper name of this, that's already you know in a unit number 5, mainly two names, either I talk about the MD5 or I talk about the SHA. What is the full form of MD5? Message digest algorithm. So must remember one thing, whenever you talk about the concept of the hash function, so hash function is also known as a message digest. So if you want to generate the message digest, so for this MD5 algorithm is there, and second algorithm, that is known as a SHA. What is the full form of SHA? Secure hash algorithm. So SHA containing the different version, but the most popular version of the SHA, that is the SHA-512. And must remember one thing, either you talk about the cryptographic hash function, either you talk about the MD5, or you talk about the SHA, that generally execute faster in software than symmetric block cipher. Symmetric block cipher means either you talk about the DES, or you talk about the AES, or you talk about the triple DES, or you talk about the double DES. What is the meaning of DES? Data Encryption Standard. What is the meaning of AES? Advanced Encryption Standard. Double DES, Double Data Encryption Standard. And triple DES means Triple Data Encryption Standard. So must remember one thing, whenever you talk about the concept of HMAC, so at that time the cryptographic hash function that execute faster than AES or DES or double DES or triple DES. And another important point regarding HMAC, library code for cryptographic hash function is widely available. So that's why using the concept of hash and MAC in a combination, and that is known as a HMAC, that is known as a hash based MAC. After that, what's the objective? All of you know the meaning of objective. But here I talk about the design objective of the MAC. Design objective of the HMAC. Why we use the HMAC and what's the design objective behind the HMAC? So first one you just see, to use without modification available hash function. Means whatever the available hash function in a security, you can directly use this particular hash function without any modification. So that is the objective number one. Objective number two, you can directly apply the replaceability of the embedded hash function in case of faster or more secure hash function are found or required. Means you can directly replace one hash function to another hash function according to the situation, according to the requirement. That is the objective number two. Objective number three, whenever you applying any particular algorithm, whenever you apply any particular technique, the most important parameter for the particular technique, that is the performance. So must remember one thing, whenever you apply a HMAC or MAC or SHA, the most important parameter to preserve the original performance of the HES function without any degrade performance. That is the most important thing. Means original performance preserving. Objective number 4. Whatever the number of key, whatever the different key used in a particular technique or used in a particular algorithm, using and handling the key in a proper way, that is the another objective. So up to this I discussed the 4 objective. Must remember according to the point. First one, without any modification use the HES function. Second one, directly apply the replaceability to one HES function to another HES function. Third one, whenever you apply any particular HES function, must remember one thing, to preserve the performance. And last one, using the key in a proper way. And the most important one, the last one, whenever you apply any authentication mechanism, so at that time the fully focus on the cryptographic analysis of the strength of the authentication mechanism. So that's all about the different objectives of the HMAC. Must remember one thing, first of all talk about the HMAC, after that definition of HMAC, third one design objective of the HMAC, then after the, because whenever you applying the MAC or message authentication or HMAC, every time the same parameter, why we require message authentication, what's the need behind the message authentication. So total number of 8 needs for the message authentication. First one, that is known as a disclosure. Already I discussed in a previous session, but that's a part of the HMAC also. So that's why again I repeat this particular topic in this particular video lecture. So first one, that is the disclosure. So disclosure means what? Release of message content. Second one, that is the traffic analysis. So traffic analysis means discovery of the pattern of traffic between the two parties. Here one, that is known as a sender. Second one, that is known as a receiver. Third one, that is known as a masquerade. Masquerade means what? One entity pretends to be another entity, but here insertion of a message into a network from a fraudulent source. Content modification means it directly changing the content of the message. Sequence modification means directly modify the sequence of the message between the two parties. Timing modification means delay or replay of the message. What is the meaning of delay in a network? What is the meaning of delay in a security? So delay means what? Whenever you apply a particular message within this particular time limit, at this particular time limit, not sending the message, but after some time you directly transmitting a message, that can be considering as a delay of the message or replay of the message. So that's the part of timing modification. After that two, source repudiation and destination repudiation. Means repudiation, that is the part of the denying the message, means here you applying the denial of transmission of message by the source as well as the denial of receipt of the message by the destination. So that is the need for the message authentication. So that's the requirement of the message authentication. And once again, already you know this particular technique, that is the part of which category. So whenever you talk about the disclosure and traffic analysis, so that is the part of the message confidentiality. Message masquerade, content modification and sequence modification, that's the part of the message authentication. And source repudiation and destination repudiation, that is the part of the digital signature. So that's all about the concept of HMAC, then after the objectives of the HMAC, and why we require the message authentication, why we require the HMAC, why we require the MAC. After that, the fully concentrate here. This is the most important part of the concept of HMAC. First of all, one diagram for this. But before this particular diagram, before I explain this particular diagram, at least you know each and every parameter in a particular diagram. So first word, that is known as a HMAC structure. So whenever you talk about the HMAC structure, so first of all the parameters of the HMAC structure. So first one, that is H. What is the meaning of H here? So H means that is known as an embedded hash function. Embedded hash function. What's the proper example of that? Either you apply the MD5 or you apply the SHA1. That is the part of the hash function. Second one, that is the IV. What is the meaning of IV? IV, that is also known as the initializing vector. But here, IV can be treated as initial value. And this particular initial value, that is input to the hash function. After that, M. M means what? M means that is the message input to HMAC. Whenever you apply any input to the message, that can be considered as a M, and that is directly applying to HMAC. After that, YI. YI means ith block of M. YI means ith block of M. After that, L. L, what does L indicate? L indicate number of block in M. Must remember one thing. M means what? That is the message. L means what? Number of block in a message. And YI means what? Ith block of M. So important three parameters here. One, that is M. Second one, that is YI. And third one, that is L. After that, N. N means what? N means length of the hash code. And length of the hash code produced by which particular function? Produced by embedded hash function. That can be considering as a N. And must remember one thing. N is equal to length of the hash code. How I generate the K plus? So K plus means all of you know the concept of key. Key means what? K. So directly applying the padding with zeros on the left side. Means one K is there, and then after you applying the padding on the left side with the zeros, whatever you generate, that can be considered as a K plus. And must remember one thing, K plus also supported B bits in a length. After that, IPAD and OPAD. IPAD means input padding and OPAD means output padding. Here I write the binary value for the 36. All of you know, if I want to represent 36 with using the binary, how I represent this thing? So 3, first 4 bit belongs to 3, last 4 bit belongs to 6. Same way for the OPAD also. First 4 bit belong to 5 and last 4 bit belongs to C. So this is the concept of the HMAC structure. Currently, I am only talking about the parameter of the HMAC structure. Again, I repeat, one that is H, one that is IV, one that is N, one that is YI, then after the L, then after the N, then after the K plus, after that IPAD, then after the OPAD. Why I repeat this? What is the reason behind that? Because in a next particular diagram, the diagram fully represent each and every parameter with using some logic. So here you just see, this is the HMAC structure. So whatever in a diagram and whatever in a steps, so start with the one by one. So first one, K plus is there and IPAD is there. All of you know the parameter. What is the meaning of K plus? How I generate the K plus? So already you know the concept of key, K. Whenever you apply the padding on that, that becomes the K plus. And IPAD means input padding, that supported some value. So first of all, if I want to generate the K plus, how I generate this? So step number one, you just see whatever I discussed here, that is the most important one. Append zeros to the left end of K to create a B bit string K plus. Means up to this clear. Step number one means what? Step number one means with using the concept of K, you directly generating a K plus with using the concept of padding. After that, step number two, here you just see in this diagram, XOR operation apply on a K plus and IPAD. Means XOR K plus with IPAD to produce the B bit block SI means whatever I generate here, that is known as a concept of SI. Up to this clear? Means what? Total number of two steps. First one, appending the zeros, generating a K plus, and second step, applying the XOR operation between the K plus and I pair to generate the S of I. After generating a S of I, then after you directly appending the message M to S of I. Here you just see in this particular figure, whatever this, that is known as a message. After appending a message to SI, then after you apply the has function. Here you just see, apply edge to the stream generated in step 3. Means whatever you generate in a step 3, you directly applying the has function on that, but at the same time using the concept of IV. IV means what? That is the initial value. That is known as an initial value, or that is known as an initialization vector. So with using this, you can directly generating a one n bit, and that is h in bracket s concatenated m. So s of I concatenated m. So whatever you generate, that is the hash code. After that, whatever the hash result you generate here, again you apply this XOR K plus with open. K plus means what? Appending the K and generating a K plus. Open containing some value. Applying the XOR operation on that. Whatever you generate, that is known as a SO. And whatever you generate in this SO, and whatever the hash code you generate in a previous step number 4, you directly concatenated or append this particular hash result to this particular step. So S0, and then after whatever this, that can be treated as a hash code. After that, the last step, whatever you generate here, again you apply the hash function on that with using the concept of IV, and whatever you generate, that is known as a HMAC in bracket K comma M. So that is known as a hash based message authentication code. Must remember one thing, what's the steps behind that? First one, with using the concept of K, applying the append operation and generating K plus. After that, applying the XOR between the K plus and I pair. Whatever you generate, that is known as a S of I. After that, you appending the message to S of I. Whatever the output, you apply the hash function on that. Whatever you receive, that is known as a concept of hash result. Again, you apply the operation between the K plus and open. Again, you apply the XOR operation between the K plus and open. Whatever you generate, that is known as a SO. And after that, whatever the hash code you generate, you directly attaching the hash code to SO. And again, you apply the hash function on that with using the concept of IV. And whatever you generate, that is known as a concept of HMAC. So this is the real procedure if you want to generate the hash based message authentication code. So that's the algorithm, that's the procedure, that's the steps for this particular technique. So that's all about the today's session. Must remember one thing in today's session: first of all, definition of HMAC. After that, design objective of the HMAC. After that, requirement of the message authentication. Then after, the talk about the HMAC structure. But in HMAC structure, first of all, talk about the different parameters that use in a part of the HMAC. After that, the steps of the HMAC. If I want to apply the procedure for HMAC, what's the proper steps behind that, and how I generate the HMAC. So that's all about the today's session. Thank you for watching.